Shri Elamaram Kareem.
Thank you, sir. The communal riots happened in our national capital is nothing but a state-sponsored terror. Sir, the recent spate of attacks in Delhi is only a short trailer of the regime that is new private-public partnership under which violence is outsourced to experienced goons. Sir, we don't have a single word or face yet that can name this phenomenon, because it is really a newest stage of ongoing project rather than a standalone event. Sir, the primary culprit in the Delhi riot is the Union Home Ministry. The inaction of the Home Ministry, despite of receiving intelligence reports on the communal tension, made situation worse. Adequate forces were not deployed even after new riots happened. When the hooligans were burning the whole northeast Delhi, Delhi police was watching the show as a mere spectator. Delhi police is under central government. But by then, goons who came from outside Delhi were escaped to their shelters when the police came. This reminded me the Gujarat riots in 2002. All the incidents and reactions by the authorities were same as that Gujarat in 2002. Ironically, those two faces who were heading the Gujarat government is heading the central government now. So we can't blame anybody if someone thinks the architects of Delhi riots in 2020, in Gujarat riots in 2002 are the same. Sir, when our country became independent from the British rule in 1947, father of our nation, Gandhiji, did not take part in the celebration of independence. Instead, he went to the streets where communal riots were going on. But when the people of Delhi were under attack, our Prime Minister was busy with the feast in Rashtrapati Bhavan with the US President. That is the difference. So after 3 days of the violence, our national security advisor visited the spot. His statement was shocking. Whatever happened has happened. Jo hua, so hua. That was his reaction. The same approach was evident in the unseemly development in Delhi High Court, where the Delhi police categorically refused to indict those who have given public speeches inciting communal polarization. He didn't even show the courtesy to say the culprits will be arrested and this kind of aggression will not be happening in the future. The riot raises so many questions also. The media reports revealed the truth. The brave young media persons went there challenging their threatening and showed the people of this country what is really happening there. I remind one of my younger brother from a Malayalam channel, Malayalam Visual Media. He reported the truth. For that, he has to pay the price. Incidentally, the chief promoter of that visual media is the chairman, is a honorable member of this house. Along with that, another Malayalam media also, they were banned 48 hours for their telecast. So, sir, now the government has appointed
please conclude.
Deputy police commissioners to go to inquire the incidents. Sir, we request a judicial probe is necessary the incident. These police officers are tainted during the Jamia Millia and JNU and Shaheen Bagh incidents. They are culprits. They are criticized by the court also and by the election commission also. So I request a judicial commission under the monitoring of a Supreme Court or a Supreme Court judge should be inquire in these incidents. We want to culminate, we want to bring peace in this area and confidence among the people at early as possible. Sir, I would like to say, I am sorry to say, the ruling government, you have blood on your hands. So you have to take stringent action against the culprits and book them in
time is
cases.
Over.
With these words, I have concluded.
Shri Truchi Shiva.
Thank you, Mr.